Welcome back. Let us discuss about the spinal cord, the second part of the central nervous system. As I told you, that central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, autonomous nervous system. Of course, the central nervous system is consisting of two parts. I told you that brain and spinal cord. Already we discussed about the brain. Now we are going to discuss about the spinal cord. Spinal cord, it is the medulla oblongata. If you take the brain, this is the medulla oblongata. It is extended long needle like structure with curves. This is called as a spinal cord. This is called a spinal cord. And the spinal cord, as the brain is covered by three layers, the same way the spinal cord also covered by three layers. What are the three layers? As I told you that earlier, there are three layers together called as the meninges. Now remember, meninges. The three layers. The first one, the outermost layer is called as the dura mater. The middle layer is called as the arachnoid matter. And the innermost layer is called as the pia mater. They are the three layers, or three layers, three membranes are presented around the brain. Even those three layers are also presented around the spinal cord also, around the spinal cord also. So the spinal cord as well as the brain will be supported by these meninges. These will protect the brain and spinal cord, especially the brain and spinal cord are protected by these meninges from the external injury as well as the shocks. And in between these layers, the space which is presented there, that is filled with a fluid like structure called as CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid. And this is the fluid which is flowing in between the layers. Right from the brain to spinal cord, spinal cord to brain. It is traveling continuously. In addition to this presenting of this CSF in the brain as well as in the spinal cord, in the spinal cord, if you take the internal structure of the spinal cord, if you take the transverse section of the spinal cord, you might be having the small canal like structure will be presented in the spinal cord. This is called central canal. This central canal also filled by CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. And cerebrospinal fluid is the fluid which protect the spinal cord from external injury. It's like a protective cushion. It's like a protective cushion for the spinal cord. And spinal cord, there are 31 pairs of spinal nerves are presented here. And all the 31 pairs are completely mixed nerves. Completely mixed nerves. Okay. It means they have the sensory regions as well as the motor regions. Already you have learned of the sensory nerves and motor nerves, which carry the information from the sense organ to brain, that is the sensory nerves, which carry the information from the brain and spinal cord to the body part, that is called motor nerves. These two are mixed in the spinal nerves. And spinal cord is mostly responsible for reflex actions. A sudden reaction which is given by the person to a stimuli, it is called as a reflex action. That we will discuss separately in the next video. Okay, the major function of the spinal cord is reflex action. It will be supporting the reflex action, because reflex actions are no need to enter into the brain. The spinal cord itself, it gives the reaction about the reflex actions. Okay, that is about the spinal cord. As I told you that earlier, the brain, the outer cortex is completely equipped with the cytons of the neurons, outer cortex, that's why it is gray matter. And axons of the neurons, white matter. So look at, listen to me here. The cytons of the neurons are present with the external area of the brain. That means the outer area of the brain, that is the gray matter. And whereas the internal area, that is the medulla, is equipped with the axons of the neuron, so it is white matter. But whereas here, if you take the internal structure of this spinal cord, the gray matter is inside, this is the gray matter, this is the gray matter is outside, and the white matter, gray matter is inside and the white matter is outside. That means that the cytons of the neurons are presented inside the spinal cord, internal area of the spinal cord, and axons of the neurons are presented external area of the spinal cord. So they make the axons make the white matter, and cytoplasm or the cytons make the gray matter inside. Gray matter is inside in the spinal cord, white matter is outside in the spinal cord. Gray matter is outside the brain, white matter is inside the brain. So it is completely vice versa, completely reverse. The arrangement of the neurons are completely reverse in the brain as well as in the spinal cord. In the brain, gray matter is outside, white matter is inside. In the spinal cord, white matter is outside, gray matter is inside. Okay, this is a very important question asking for 2 marks in the examination. Write the differences between the brain and spinal cord with regards of the arrangement of the neurons. 2 marks question, compulsorily you have to remember this. Okay, don't forget it. It's very, very important. Okay, that is about the spinal cord. Okay, now we are moving to the another nervous system, that is the peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous Again, the somatic nervous system is consisting of 2 types of neurons here. That is cranial nerves, spinal nerves. And autonomous nervous system is consisting of 2 systems again here, sympathetic. Another type of nervous system, that is peripheral nervous system, somatic nervous system as well as the autonomous nervous system, it is completely. And in the somatic nervous system, you might be learning the 2 types of nerves. I told you already, neurons are different, nerves are different. Already in the first video, we have discussed about this. Neurons are the nerve fibers, and number of nerve fibers are combined together form the nerves. Okay, so such nerves, cranial nerves as well as the spinal nerves, the nerves which are originated from the medulla oblongata of the brain. The nerves which are originated from the medulla oblongata of the brain are called as cranial nerves, and these are of 12 pairs, like optic nerve, auditory nerve, olfactory nerve. These are the some of the examples of the cranial nerves, and vagus nerve which control the heartbeat. These are the some of the examples of the cranial nerves. There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves are there, and these 12 pairs of cranial nerves will conduct the sensory information as well as the motor information and also mixed information. That means that these cranial nerves may act as a sensory neurons, sensory nerves, and motor nerves as well as the mixed nerves also. Okay, and next one is the spinal nerves. There are 31 pairs of spinal nerves are presented. 31 pairs. Suppose if you take the spinal cord, this is the spinal cord. It is having the region, this is the neck region, neck, lumbar, sacral, occipital. These are the four regions are presented here. In this neck region, 8 pairs of spinal nerves will be presented. Lumbar region, 5 pairs. Sacral region, 5 pairs. Occipital region, 1 pair. Yes, one more region I forgot it. This is thoracic region. Thoracic. Lumbar. Thoracic region, 7 pairs, 5 pairs, 5 pairs, totally 12 pairs. So these are the total spinal nerves. 31 pairs of spinal nerves will be presented. 31 pairs. 8 pairs, 12 pairs, 20. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 20, 30. And 1 pair is occipital region. In this, totally spinal nerves are presented. All the spinal nerves are mixed nerves. All the spinal nerves are completely mixed nerves. It means they may be act as a sensory nerves, they may be act as a motor nerves also. Which one? The spinal nerves. Completely mixed nerves. And come to the next one is autonomous nervous system. See, sometimes we will get the angriness, we will get the more hungriness, dizziness, and we will be grief. That means we want something. However, we have also will be wanting something. Grief, greediness. These all emotions of the body are controlled by autonomous nervous system. In these two systems are again presented, that is sympathetic nervous system, parasympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system speed up the body functions. When we do the exercises, our heartbeat will be increases. Why the heartbeat will be increases here? Because when we are doing the exercises, our muscles will be working harder. They need more oxygen. So to provide more oxygen to the body, to the muscles of the body, the heart beats faster, so that it can pump the blood more in amount. And the RBC which are presented there in the blood, they can get hold of the oxygen, more amount of oxygen, and supply to the muscular activities there in the time of exercise. So that when we are doing exercise, our heartbeat increases. When we are running, our heartbeat increases. So these are all the speed up our body. Suppose two of them are quarreling each other, and one of them got very much high range of angriness, and he used to beat that person. So this is because of the sympathetic nervous system. It will increase the body functions, speed up the body functions, and whereas the parasympathetic nervous system, it will slow down the body functions. Suddenly, if there is a full of light in a room like this, full of light is there, and you are reading some book, suddenly power gone off. So immediately you will feel the blindness. You cannot find anything, and slowly your eyes will be adjusted with the darkness, and you will be opening your eyes wider. You will be opening your eyes wider, and you are seeing the things like this. Your wideness means eyes will not be increased. The pupil which is present, the black spot, the pupil which is presented in the eye, that will be extended, dilated. This dilation is because of the sympathetic nervous system. And when the power comes, slowly the dilation of the pupil will come downwards. That means come slow down and come to the normal position. That is called constriction. So dilation and constriction. Dilation because of the sympathetic nervous system, constriction because of the parasympathetic nervous system. This is one example I told you. Slow down, make the all the body functions in a normal condition. That is because of the parasympathetic nervous system, and the speed of the body functions according to the requirement of the oxygen, or according to the requirement of the body, the speed up of the body functions is because of the sympathetic nervous system. So these two are comparatively work opposite. One is speed up the body functions, one is slow down the body functions. Okay, this is the autonomous nervous system. So that our body functions, so though we are very much high angriness also, slowly our angriness will be come down and will be normal in condition. That because of the parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, in this way, once imagine if these two systems are not there, or parasympathetic is not there, one can go on increasing this speed of the body functions, and finally the person dies. So when the body functions are speed up because of the sympathetic nervous system, automatically high BP, high stress, and it will lead to the some other chronic disease in the body. That's why parasympathetic is compulsory for the human beings. It will come completely normal, make the normalize the complete body functions, slow down the body functions by this parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, and this is about the complete nervous system. And next video we will discuss about the reflex actions. It's also a very important topic. We'll discuss about the reflex actions in the next video. Thank you very much.